But even though I thought about this solution, I forgot to turn off my fucking microphone on the recording. Whatever. Skip the intro. Hello everybody, today we will be testing out the official Oculus cable, and alongside with that, I have a pulley system that is kinda goes with it, apparently. I mean, apparently. I kinda like bought it before the link was announced because I kinda like knew I wanted like... No, I'm fucking lying. Actually, I bought it when link released, but like the cable was released way after that, and the fucking Europe delay triggering, but I don't know what Oculus was thinking about that. So I have a official Oculus cable, right? I was testing this out for the past few days. I was mainly playing Until You Fall, Asgore, and I think Skyrim. I'm not even sure, like I was just recording and just like testing out if things change, kinda. Because normally I have my anchor cable, right? That 3-meter one that Oculus Block kinda like recommended in a place of the official their Oculus Link cable for the time period that they are gonna like kinda produce, whatever. The pulley system is here. Basically, I don't know how the fuck that I will just show it. Basically, you have that the cable goes from the bottom of the wardrobe from my computer all the way up from my wardrobe, then it skips on the ceiling on the pulleys here, and then I basically just like take off from the wall and then just like have hanging around, right? Now it's gonna be dangling here, just like a fucking whatever. It's not safe for work. It's kinda like it is in a perfect position because before on Link I was playing like right beside my monitor, right? Some people saw on my playthroughs. Like the movement was so fucking restricting that it was crazy, especially in Asgore. It was a problem for me because I have two setups, right? I have a Quest setup that I'm playing on my bed, and I had a setup Link beside the monitor. Now I will be using from the now. The same setup that I had from Quest and Link would be all in the same place. With my thought process, I went with, because I wanted a Link experience basically how I would play normally Quest games, right? My apartment is kind of like, you know, it's really packed, not packed, it's like really small, but it's like resolved in a way that I can have things like close to my proximity, so I can have like the same Quest setup as Link. I don't know what I'm doing. In a few weeks or and actually this week, because The Walking Dead is releasing, you will see how it works. Or maybe you already saw on the Until You Fall gameplay, right? So it's basically the same thing, but I wanted to have a freedom of movement just like in a Quest games playing Link. That was my philosophy, and that's why I went with the pulley system, because I kind of like knew that it's gonna work here, and the cable, official Oculus Link cable, will be sufficient for that, right? I actually thought it's gonna be like too short, but it's like too long, and it's like the setup is so perfect that I'm really surprised by how it works. If we're talking about the actual cable, let's go into that. So I can compare my anchor cable and the official one. We need to split it, like, I guess, people into groups, because the cable for one group is great, but the other is useless, right? And not many people will tell you that. First of all, the anchor cable was like, I don't know, 15 euro, whatever, just like really cheap for a cable. There is one group that wanna have an experience, like just feel full normal experience, right? But they don't want like just really like, I guess, I would say pro consumer solutions. So for example, my first gameplay mode was just like next to my monitor, and it was fine. Like it was not that bad, but like it was personally a little bit constricting because the cable was only 3 meters. To have a Link experience fully, it was pretty much alright. The official one is 2 meters longer. It's purely for people who plan playing games that are really movement-wise, right? So for example, my style of playing games is I really use pretty much all the time smooth locomotion with just like, you know, thumbstick, right? I don't really move around. Maybe I'll like dodge something, Beat Saber or whatever, but I'm not really like a high movement player. Although I like having freedom of movement, even though I don't really use that, right? That's kind of like why Quest for me is a really good headset, and that's how I wanted Link setup to be. And that's how I resolved that. If we're talking about the graphics, whatever, performance, it's pretty much indistinguishable the same. And I feel like everyone tells that, right? It's basically the same, the latency is the same, everything is pretty much the same, and it's basically because that the actual USB-C output is not fully, I would say, supported by Link currently. I think kind of like supported. The bandwidth is just not fully supported by that because the software is not designed for it for now. It's kind of like they created the cable with a thought that in the future that they will be utilizing that like next year, 2 years from now, whatever. So it's kind of like the official Oculus cable is kind of treated like an investment rather than like a really consumer ready purchase. Even though it works, everything is fine. It's not fully like usable. It doesn't use full its potential. That's the thing. The price, obviously, it's way fucking pricier. It's like in Europe especially, it's basically £19 and like €19, which is crazy. When in US it's like not even, I think, $80, which the currency is brutal, hey? Now, if you're talking about the issues, because y'all know, with playing Link, I have a really distinguishable issue. And I feel like at this point I know pretty much exactly what's happening. So basically, because I tested out, especially with Antifall, how it works. So I have a comparison with Anchor and the Oculus cable. Basically, when I play Link alone, like I guess not recording anything, just purely gameplay to my headset, everything works perfectly, right? There are no issues, no disconnections, no nothing. But then from the moment that I start recording, something goes wrong along the way. So basically, and it's pretty much all the time the same thing. After half an hour of recording, the first disconnection, then after 15 minutes, 20 minutes, 5 minutes, then it's just not usable for about the next couple hours. And I don't know really what's the issue. I feel like it's purely because Link is still in beta testing, so I really hope that it is that's the problem, because that was not actually the cable issue. I had the same exact issues on the Anchor cable and on the Oculus one, so I don't really blame the cable for that. I blame kind of the software, right? I bought the cable in hopes that this will solve it, but it's not really solving anything other than movement, I guess, setup, which I guess is fine. I guess fair trade-off, right? I mean, I don't really mind investing in a high-end cable in case that the software will upgrade, because it will upgrade in the future. I'm not worried about that. It's just that it's frustrating because the recording process, as we all know, is just like a shit show on Quest. And then when you switch from Quest to Link, it's even worse. You really, like, I'm really fucking persistent in making those YouTube videos, even though I don't really do much of editing. Believe me, there is a lot of fucking issues with audio, with anything. Sometimes I need to slow down the audio. Sometimes there is no audio at all. I'm looking at your recent Quest releases. It's pure shit show. That's pretty much why most people don't do it, or they do it. But as a content creator, I can see that they didn't pay attention to those issues, little issues. Some people there are little issues, but for me it's kind of like annoying. So when something is delayed in the video, I want to just like kill myself, I want to just like delete the whole video. It's just terrible. At least for me, I'm kind of like a perfectionist I guess, in editing, even though I do minimal stuff. Believe me, I put work into it because it's not easy. It's not just recording screen and just playing games. It's there are a lot of things that go into, especially in the Quest headset. So conclusion about the cable, it's just that you don't need to get the official cable to have a full experience of Link library. It's pretty much that, because I understand not everyone can afford something like that. Like, I can, because I work my ass off and like I care about stuff like movement, right? And I record videos, so whatever. But like, most of the people will go by pretty much fine with the basically any cable that you can kind of connect to the headset. Really, like, you don't really need the Oculus one. But to the other group, to the second group that like want something higher end, you should buy the cable. And it segues to my system of pulley system. It's pretty much goes well with the cable. It's like, it utilizes the space so well that I actually was like surprised that I kind of pull it up here. I'm kind of like privileged to have an apartment constructed in this way that I can play Link like that on my bed, because it's really fucking comfortable now. Jesus Christ, when I played Asgaroth for the first time with this setup, you'll see, oh my god, it was such a difference. It was like the gameplay was so much easier and just like so smoother. Like, I felt like I was actually like in the game, not like pulling my head with the cable. So it was crazy, and you know, it's definitely a different feeling playing Link games with that. The pulleys are really like, see, they are really strong. Like, even though I will like, you know, pull stuff, and you know, because I have that on the tapes on the ceiling, and they work like amazingly. You can just like move in every direction that I did here, pull, and nothing fucking moves. Like, the tape does not come off, like everything is pretty much perfect. So I really like that I went with this idea. It will like show on the videos that I'm much more comfortable and just much happier playing games, because it is a good thing. I'm not sure that I summarized it well, but that's kind of like my thoughts on the situation. You know, we'll be having actually like this Thursday, which will be my birthday actually. Happy birthday, boy. 25, Jesus Christ, that's crazy. We'll be playing The Walking Dead because it releases on the same day, basically. But yeah, it sucks that I did not resolve the issues with my recording regime, but you can't do much when the software is still beta, right? I mean, I guess I need to waste more time on just like correcting audio issues and stuff like that, but hey. I mean, I like this shit and I like posting videos on my channel, so I don't really mind that. It's just that I waste time on some useless stuff, but at the end of the day, if that's the price for me having this channel, hey. Also, I didn't mention, basically in the box with the cable, it comes like a clip on the headset, right? The clip itself is really tight, so if you clip it on the cable, it kind of like not destroys the cable, but it's kind of like the rubber is like kind of squished, right? And this is a good tip. So what I do is that I kind of, before squinching the cable, I kind of like try to make it a little bit loose and then put the cable. That way your cable obviously won't move, but you by removing and putting it into the clip, your cable would not get destroyed over time. Like, once, two times, it's fine when you just do straight up that, but when you do it like 15 times, your cable will eventually break. So basically I just kind of like relax a little, put the cable, and that's it. And that's the clip. My position on the headset, however, this is pretty much the setup. I put the cable, then, because I have this pulley system, so pretty much everything is from above, I have the cable connected here, then the clip goes just right next to my ear. Then I have a Velcro tape here just to kind of like add it, like make sure the cable does not like really like hang around, right? Because the cable kind of like is long enough to twist on my head, so I just make sure it won't like just wander around, even though it does not secure shit. It's kind of like it secures just in one position that it's like above my head, not like next to my ear, right? So that's pretty much my position, and I found that it's pretty much the perfect for me. Long story short, and I should do that in the beginning, if you don't have the money, you don't need the official Oculus cable, just buy the normal one and you will pass by. If you have the budget, you can, you don't need to. I would recommend buying the cable if you care about movement and the longevity, I guess, of Link, right? That's pretty much it. Okay, great. I mean, I guess that's it. So we'll see each other, obviously, tomorrow and after tomorrow. But like after tomorrow in Thursday, will be the newest, pretty much me. Just straight up fucking bullshit game on birthday. I mean, I'm actually happy that I will be spending my birthday on playing the game. That's nothing new, but okay.